comedians with disabilities act, we have to travel from time to time, sometimes a little far away. And if that's the case, then I have to fly. Wheelchairs and airplanes, not a great mix, not a good time, as some of you in here tonight know. Some of you others may disagree, maybe say, no, no, not so. I've seen you wheelchair people at the airport gates. You get to board the plane first, while the rest of us must wait. I don't really think you guys talk like that. I don't know why I'm doing that voice. But it's true, we do get to board the plane first. For me, though, that's kind of like being first person in line on free colonoscopy day. Yeah. Going first is not really a perk, so. But we do have to do that. I have to do that because this wheelchair does not fit down the aisle of an aircraft. So I have to get seated in those first couple of rows. Now that's great if it's the origin point of a flight and those are empty. But if it's a continuing flight and there's people already filled into those, I have to sit further back in the plane. And to use that, I have to use something called the aisle chair. Yeah, some of you in here know what I'm talking about with the aisle chair. Good Lord. For those of you who don't, let me break it down for you. This is, aisle chair is a chair, and I use the term loosely, about as wide as a skateboard. It's basically like a Tetris-shaped metal plank with little roller skate wheels on the bottom of it. And what they do is, they put me in this thing, and they strap my legs together so I don't fall off, and then they strap my arms together so my elbows don't hit people on the way by. And then they strap my back to the back of the thing, basically leaving me trussed up like Hannibal Lecter without the face mask. And then they drag me backwards down the aisle like a beverage cart. Now, this is all kind of awkward and humiliating just on its own. But the last time I flew, they got me all the way back to my row, and who had to be seated there all alone? Gorgeous young brunette, beautiful girl. Now, we've all flown before. What are the chances of actually getting seated next to someone attractive? Never happens. Never happens. I usually get sort of like the hairy Eastern European woman with the screaming baby. Baby's already got a mustache. Almost as thick as his mother's. Or the portly gentleman who smells of pork rinds and loneliness, who has the least interesting life story ever, and yet has been commanded by God to share it with the world. I never get the hot girl. And the one time I finally do, I mean, dragged down the aisle, chained to some kind of dominatrix Bowflex. There's just no way to look cool after that. Now, to the girl's credit, though, she took it in stride. She did okay. She saw me, and she looked over, and she said hi. So I looked over at her. I said, hello, Clarice. Thank you, everyone, for being here tonight. My name is Michael O'Connell. Enjoy the rest of the show.